With the last video in our Learn to Code series, at least for now, there will probably be more videos on learning to code, but it will not be in this specific set of problems. So as always, definitely make sure that you watch the first video in the playlist, which I have above, to make sure that you have your environment set up so that you can follow along. And with that, let's get into the topic for today. So today we are doing the optional bonus problem, which is MidpointKarel.py. So it says, as an exercise in solving algorithmic problems, program Karel to place a single beeper at the center of First Street, aka row. For example, say Karel starts in the 5x5 world pictured in the figure. Okay, this is the beginning state. Karel should end with Karel standing on a beeper in the following position, which is at column 3. Then it says, note that the final configuration of the world should have only a single beeper at the midpoint of First Street. Along the way, Karel is allowed to place additional beepers wherever it wants to, but must pick them all up again before it finishes. Similarly, if Karel paints or colors any of the corners in the world, they must all be uncolored before Karel finishes. Okay. In solving this problem, you may count on the following facts about the world. Karel starts at the bottom left corner facing east with an infinite number of beepers in its back, which this was the bottom left corner facing to the right. The initial state of the world includes no interior walls or beepers, okay? The world need not be square, but you may assume that it is at least as tall as it is wide. Okay, so basically if it's not square, then like this could be like a 5x, and it could be like 7 rows tall, but it wouldn't be like 5 and then like 3 rows tall. Okay, it says your program, moreover, can assume the following simplifications. If the width of the world is odd, Karel must put the beeper in the center square, which, yeah, so this is 5, so that's odd, and then this is the center square. If the width is even, Karel may drop the beeper on either of the two center squares. So basically, if we pretend that the fifth column doesn't exist, then what it's saying is that the beeper can either be in 2 or in 3. It doesn't matter which one it is. Then it says it doesn't matter which direction Karel ends up facing at the end of the run. There are many different algorithms you can use to solve this problem, so feel free to be creative. You should make sure that your program runs successfully in all of the following worlds. Blah, blah, blah. We'll look at this later. Okay, cool. So let's go to our PyCharm. And as always, we take our template.py, Command C, Command V, and I type midpointKarel.py. Okay. So how do we do this? Karel has to find the midpoint. Now, first thing we ask ourselves is, okay, well, if we knew how wide the world was, how would we find the midpoint? Like, what is even the midpoint, right? So this is a math problem. Now, some of you may be thinking, oh my God, math, I hated math, but this isn't too bad. So we said, okay, let's assume we know the width. So let's just write width equals 5, right? We assume we know the width, because in this example world, it is 5. So we can worry about that later. So then we said, okay, but how do I know which square I want to put it on? So what they told me is that if it's 5, which this is, then I need to put the beeper in column 3. Now, one thing that's going to help us here is, in real computer science world, generally we would start numbering from 0. So this would be 0, this would be 1, this would be 2, 3, and 4. So the reason why that is helpful is because we have this thing called integer arithmetic. So if I use integer arithmetic, right, the midpoint is halfway. So how do I find the halfway point? I divide by 2. So if I have 5, and then I divide by 2, I get 2.5 or 2.5. But 2.5, there's no column 2.5. But if I use integer arithmetic, then that 2.5 is just going to become 2. So what I can do is, if this is 0 and this is 1 and this is 2, that's exactly where I need to put it. So I'm like, cool. So if I start counting from 0, then all I have to do is divide my width by 2 using integer arithmetic, and then I'll get 2, and that'll tell me which column I'm supposed to put it in, right? Now, you might say, oh, but what if you have an even number? Okay, if I had 4 and I divide by 2, then I get 2, right? So So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2. And they told us that it was okay if I put it either here or here, so this still works. So basically that will work either way. So what we're gonna do is, assuming we have the midpoint, we're gonna say, okay, I'll just put steps equals, and then I'll say int of width divided by 2. Now, the reason why I have to do this int here is because in another language, I would actually have like written it like this, int steps equals blah, blah, blah. So I have to actually tell it that I want it to do integer arithmetic. If I don't tell it that, then what it's going to do is it's just going to put 2.5 here. And that's not what I want to do. So if we knew that the width was 5, I could just say, okay, well, steps is going to equals this. And then all I have to do is do a loop. I need to take that many of steps. So I'll say for I in range. So we haven't talked about this. We haven't really talked about for loops too much. We've mainly been doing a lot of while loops. So for loops are a little bit different. So a common way that a for loop would be written is it would be written something like this, for like int I equals 0. Then it would be I less than steps I plus plus. So you would typically see something like this in, like, let's say another language like Java. So this is the same thing, but I'm writing it like this just to explain. So what this is basically saying is start at 0, count up to steps, and then increment by 1 each time. That's what this is saying. I plus plus is just adding 1. So alternatively, I could write this, or alternatively, I could write this. All these mean the same thing. Okay, but yeah, so that's basically what this is saying. So what this means is I would have 0. So in this case, steps is 2, right? So I would say I is 0, and then I say, okay, 0 is less than 2, so I do whatever I need to do. Then I say, I increment I to 1, 1 is still less than 2, I do what I need to do. Then I get to 2, but 2 is not less than 2, so I'm not going to do anything. So I'm not quite sure if this is gonna work, because I think I actually need to take 3 steps and not just 2 steps. So I think I actually need to do plus 1. So in this case, I could type less than or equal to. Actually, let me go back. Let me show you, right? So we start here. Actually, no, I do need to take 2 steps. So I start here, I take 1 step and I'm here, and then I take 1 step. So 2 steps is exactly what I need to do. So disregard what I just said. This is exactly what we need. So I'm gonna erase this. So what we said is we need to just take that many steps. So I'm going to take 2 steps. So I'm just going to move 2 times. And then once I'm done moving, then I just put down a beeper. Now this should work, right? If the width is 5. So let's just see. What is the world? It was midpoint finding Karel dot W. So let's try to, oops, that's the wrong one. Run, midpoint Karel, run program. Okay, now this isn't working, right? Because you can see this is 9. So we assumed it was 5, so it put it at 3. But let's change this to a world where it actually is 5. So I think 3x5 should work. I'm not sure. Let's find out. Is that the right one? No. We need like a 5x3. Yeah, 5x3. Now they gave us some assumptions, but for what we're doing, we don't actually care. Okay, cool. So yeah, so for 5, it does work, right? So we did verify that our program works correctly with width 5. But what if the width is not 5? Then what do we do? It's a good question. So we need to find the width, right? So let's change this. Let's just do find width, right? So let's write a function. How do we find the width? This is not something that we've done before. So all we're going to do to find the width is we're literally going to just start from the beginning, and we're going to just walk until the end, and we're going to count how many squares there are. We're literally just going to count how many steps we can take before we hit a wall. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say while front is clear. So I'll say width equals 1 because I know that it's at least 1, right? So while the front is clear, I'm going to width plus, plus, plus. Actually, it doesn't work here. Plus equals 1. And then I'm going to move. So I'm just going to, I'm counting how many steps I'm taking and I'm walking to the wall. And then when I get done, I'm going to return width. So let's see. We got the width. Let's try to run this and let's see what happens now. Ooh, program crashed. What is the problem? Looks like we ran into this wall. Now, so here we walked to the wall. We got our width. Then we returned our width and we calculated our steps. Oh, but then we tried to move again. Now, what we need to do is we need to turn around. Because obviously, we came over here, we walked all the way to the wall, but we never turned around and went back. So in this case, what we did is we're gonna walk all the way to the wall, we're gonna find out that the width is 5. Then we're gonna calculate, okay, 5 divided by 2 using integer arithmetic is gonna give me 2. So I need to take 2 steps. But I can't walk this way, so I need to turn around and then take 2 steps, and then I'll be where I need to be. So we've added our turnaround, and we're just gonna do this again, def turn around, which was turn left and turn left again. Now this should be better. So let's try this again. Why? Oh, it's just telling me to add another blank line because there's some syntax conventions that we're supposed to be following. Okay. This actually worked now. So we actually went to the end, we turned around, and we found the middle. So that's good. This worked with 5. So let's try something else. Let's see if we try this. Let's try this 1 by 8. Because why not? Okay, that worked. Let's try 3 by 3. Okay, that worked. Did we just do 3 by 5? I don't know, but we about to do it. I think we did 5 by 3. Yeah, we did 5 by 3. So we'll do 3 by 5. Okay, that worked too. We already did 5 by 3. We're not gonna do 6 by 5 because that's gonna be the same as 3 by 5. We'll do 7 by 7. Nice, that worked too. And let's just do 8 by 8 because, or 8 by 1, it doesn't really matter. Because of the way that we wrote our program, we never try to go up. Okay, so is this the middle? So I have 3 on this side and I have 4 on this side. So yeah, that counts because they told me that I could put it in either of the 2 middle spaces. So that means I could either put it at 4, which I did, or I could have put it at 5 because both of these 2 are the middle. So that still works. Okay, so I don't think we have anything else. So let me just do the midpoint finding one again. And if this works, then we are done. Let's try. Nice. Success. We did it. We have programmed Karel to find the midpoint in addition to all the other things that we have programmed Karel to do. So I hope you learned something from this video and honestly the series in general. If you did, please be on the lookout for the rest of my videos. And in the meantime, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with all your friends. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Lord, I worship you. Because of who I give you glory, because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are. All right. Hello, Tiffany Arielle here, and this is a test shot.